Brilliant, now you're all assembled around the fire. And it's a nice thing to do when you come to other cultures. You share stories. And I've travelled from the wilds of almost Scotland. I've come from the Scottish border through Newcastle. Let me tell you, it's a dark place. You should never go there.
We should go in and
rained all the time. It's full of Lancastrians.
Well, I don't know how that works.
However, as I travelled down, we drove past a lot of signs for Wales, and it reminded me of a few of the great stories of Wales. They haven't got much else to do. Their national sport is singing, I believe. Who'd have thought? But there is a very old tale from Wales. I noticed we had a fiddler, and I thought, why the hell not? Let me tell you the tale of Iolo Ap Iorwerth. The greatest fiddle player in the whole of Wales, which isn't saying much because there were only three of them.
But that's not Mark is the best tap dancer in the
country. Iolo was commissioned to the King of Wales, to Cadwallon. Now, Cadwallon was a man of great luxury. He liked the finer things in life, the best mead, the best of the ladies, and the best of his music and dances. So he commissioned Iolo to play the fiddle for him. And he would turn at the feasts and say, Iolo, play me a merry tune.
Oh, yes, very good.
And he took a king's commission. He was playing royally. Oh, great round rings of gold he wore. Never shy for coin at the bar was Iolo. But too much ale, too much mead, too much red meat, too much of the good life leads a man to think somewhat on where he comes from and what it is he's doing. And after many years in the king's service, Iolo felt that maybe he'd lost something. And maybe his music needed more focus. Maybe he needed to concentrate himself. And he took it into his mind that he should go back to the wilds, as I'm sure many of you have done, and reconnect with the spirit of the earth, and reconnect with the spirit of his sound. So he took himself out onto the beaches of Wales and wandered the cliffs until he found a cave. And as he walked in playing the fiddle, he heard it echo back to him. He went, I could make my home here. I could be very happy here. Perhaps I will stay a while. So he took himself into the cave. He lived well for a time. But, as often happens, people that spend too long on their own in wild places go a bit strange. Then Iolo went very strange. I hear told he found another note between A sharp and B. And he called it Iolo's note, and it only worked in that one cave. You'll agree, he must have been stark raving bonkers. Well, for many years, nothing was heard of Iolo Ap Iorwerth, and he passed from common thoughts into folklore, into legend, into memory. And down the generations, stories were told of a man who lived too richly and lost his way. Now, as I hear told, four or five generations later, a young man was sat in the local tavern drinking heavily of the local beer. Strong beer and a weak composition, as often happens in Wales. Far too much time underground, not enough sunlight. Very strange bunch. Is anyone from Wales? Yeah. Marvellous, I know who to come and apologise for. But he was contingent on this. Iolo was used more as a boatman, as a story to scare kids to bed. Go to bed before it gets dark. or Yolo will come and get you. He'll come out of his cave, playing his fiddle and swinging his lamp, and he'll drag you in, and you'll never be seen or heard from again. Well, as young men often do, after strong drink, he made proud to boast, "I'm not scared! I'll go and look for Yolo. It'll be fun. It'll be great. I'll go and look for Yolo. It'll be amazing. I'll come back in the morning and you'll all see..." I can't do a well done, don't I? "I'll come back in the morning and you'll all see you're full of rubbish." Well, they weren't the exact words he used, but they're arguing here, so I'll let you imagine. "You'll see, it's just a tale." So he wandered down to the beach, and he listened, and he heard the woeful tune of the fiddle on the wind. You've all had it, that moment when your bum goes... You realise you might have made a horrible mistake, but you're probably too committed now to turn around and go back. So he began to wander along the beach, and the tales he'd heard all through his childhood of the enchanting music taking you away and binding your mind and muddying your reason would lead you to his cave, and you'd never be seen again. And he thought, "Oh, this is bad. This is really bad. If I see a swinging light, I'm probably going to poo myself." And then, on the headland, he saw a strange sight, a lantern swinging, broken and disjointed, with the mournful fiddle playing. As he closed, he could see the light of the lantern reflecting on an old, withered man, not moving right, everything broken and disjointed as he played. For Yolo had lived far, far beyond his years. Maybe 200 plus years have passed since he disappeared from Cadwallon's court. And the man thought, "No, it's a trick of the light. It's something playing on my brain. It'll be a ship out at sea." But then he realised the tide was a long way out, and there was no way it could be the swinging lights, and he knew he should stop. But something about the music compelled his feet. And if you were there last night outside of the big performance marquee in Touchy Underday, you know what I mean. You can't help yourself. You've got to go in and see what's happening, haven't you? Audience participation, folks. Well, that's a good question. You can't help yourself, can you? You've got to go.
Yes!
And his feet carried him in, and the closer he got, the less mournful the playing became, and the faster the gig, the faster he moved. And he couldn't help himself. His feet followed one after the other across the sand. No matter how hard he tried to turn and run, he just couldn't help himself. It carried, and it kept going. Going until he came to the mouth of the cave, and the music washed over him like a great breaking wave. And he danced, he spun, and he threw the cave.